Hello everyone, Sunset.2, and welcome to part 2 of my Mechanized mod overview. So, continuing on, we have the steam piston, which is made with iron, brass, and pistons. And what this allows you to do is obviously have a piston that is steam powered. So, for example, if we do this here, we just remove the following, because we don't really want those to interact. We put more in here, water and steam. Water and coal to generate steam. You should have it where it, I'm pretty sure, pushes blocks or certain other things in the direction it's facing on that end. So just do that. I don't think we need a lever either to do this. It's just steam power. And yep, so it's not going to with the redstone signal. I don't think it restricts it either, similar to the bricket and placer. I don't know how long it'll take though. I think it has to be possibly similar to my theory with the pump, is that it needs 100 pressure before it'll actually do anything. But that might take a while. So I'm gonna probably need a few more of these, for example, to actually make that happen. And there's also steam going in there, which is great, so the pipes don't really direct it to one specific thing, they just do to whatever inventory they have access to. That seems to be not really going up at all. Pressure seems to be balancing it out elsewhere. Oh well. Either way. Next, we have the fan, which is made like so. The fan blade with iron. You just get a boiler, pipe, and a fan. We'll see if it can actually push blocks away, as well as mobs, which you could use in quite a useful way. So we'll just see what happens once it has enough. My guess is it probably won't push mobs, but it might item entities. Again, it does take quite a bit, I guess, for many of these to operate. And I don't know if they're also controlled by redstone, because I'm pretty sure they don't really react to it all too much. So, there's definitely pressure here, just it takes a bit to push them. Not too sure. Again, we're going to probably need quite a lot. Just not sure how to go about that exactly, since it does seem to take a bit. But either way, it probably does work. My guess is it obviously will detail more in the book, which produces an air current in front and behind that can move entities. The current in front pushes, while the one at the back sucks. This current gets stronger and extends further the more pressure the fan is given. Its internal tank can hold one unit of steam. Be disabled with the redstone signal, so unlike the others, that's the case. Other than that, we have the pressure valve, which is a way of letting out steam, made with a iron trapdoor and brass ingots. If you have too much steam, you can then obviously limit how much is in the pipe, so that's just a guide of what it currently is set to. If we go to 1, you can see that it's letting out as much as it can. You can see it being let out. If we want to change it, we can change it to 100, so that once it gets to 100, which is obviously the maximum there, you can see it will let it out once it's full. I don't know if you can also use a redstone signal with that. It doesn't say anything. We have the steam charger, made like so, which is obviously useful for the armour, which we'll also cover now. So there's steam canisters and a few other things. For many of these, I guess the steam canisters are only for recipes, not for actually storing things portably, but we'll find out. So we'll want, obviously, to put some armour on here. We want a basic boiler set up, and we'll want a pipe set up here. Then from there, we should be able to charge this. So just right click, and you'll see no durability is filled up there. Other than that, we've got the upgrade table made with brass ingots and smooth stone, which we can use obviously to upgrade the armor. Let me see the following slots available currently. So, yeah. So, one upgrade, two upgrades on the helmet, one on the boots, and on the leggings, also one. We'll actually find out over time what can be applied to these. So, durability, like so. I don't think it changes the armor at all. But that'll take a bit, obviously, to fill it up with steam. We do, however, also have the drill, which is made like so. This will pretty much be your pickaxe of sorts. Again, I'm obviously going to need to wait quite a bit for these to be charged up. And yeah, that's pretty much the mod at the current time. Besides the steam fraction, which I've also forgotten. I can hold one new steam item for them. Okay, so they can be used besides being just a crafting material. Let's see, it can dig stone. More pressure, depends on it being faster. It can also be upgradable, which we'll just see some of the upgrades so I don't forget. Seem to add another steam canister to increase the steam size. Diamond to make it diamond level, since they're most likely iron. As well as a bucket for also vacuuming up and dissipating lava and water. Water is evaporated using some of the drill steam. Lava is used as a fuel source to repressurize. Okay. I'll try the armor as well, so don't forget. Exosuit boots can redirect energy from a fall into a higher jump. While they have steam, you take less fall damage. Additionally, if you jump at the moment of impact, you'll go higher. You can amplify muscle movements, move slightly faster. The leggings, you can have additional strike power to your arms, so I'm assuming extra damage. While it has steam, you deal one more heart of damage. For melee, and the helmet doesn't have any passive benefits, but can take two upgrades instead of one. You've got the following, such as the canister, upgrading your amount of armor than the usual, a piston for knockback at a guess, no jump height. So jump height of 3 blocks, most likely used for the boots of course. An eye vendor can be used to upgrade it for night vision, and a spectral arrow can be used for granting the ability to see creatures through walls, which is quite useful. So yeah, we'll also go to the fraction tower, and we'll still wait for those to charge up. And let's see, a 3 block high machine will pressurize a large amount of steam and inject into the earth. This flushes out rocks and sand, but also ores and dusts. Material washes it with bubbles and a wide radius. Yeah, so it pretty much seems like the quarry of the mod for the most part. So that's filling up quite well. Also try hooking up a chest on top or so. We'll see with boilers, we'll actually get the blast one just in case to make it a lot easier to send this steam to it. I probably could also go with the creative method as well, which I've also gotten. Let's see, does it actually require on top, maybe? That's why. There we go. So we get coal. No problem. We get the pressure gauge. We'll see if it's not doing too much yet. Probably needs the 100. Actually, no, it's filling up exceptionally quick now. Just get the following here, and we'll send more over if possible, or to probably just flow through the rest, but who cares, we'll actually see what we can do with three connected to the top, and my guess is you probably can't use this on the bottom as it'll break blocks below it, at a guess, or it just maybe does the sort of send it to an inventory approach, I guess? We'll find out, since this is taking a bit to do things. So to check back on the leggings as well, which they maybe have. No, it's still going. So, yeah. So that's over. We'll actually see what happens next. Nothing yet. Okay, so we'll try a hopper and chest, if it doesn't actually break anything below. It just sends out stuff to inventories, maybe. Nothing. There's nothing yet, unless you need it to be filled on all three levels, which is also likely. Otherwise, though, if we just cover a few other things before I forget. There's also a frame, which just seems to be the case here, possibly just part of the sort of texturing there. No recipe, just decoration. And you've got the creative source as well, if you want to test stuff out, which I probably might do about now, since I'm going to need a bit more. Okay, so it just has things appear above it. We'll just go into spectator and see what happens. So it is taking blocks out of spaces randomly, even at lower depths. Interesting. So, yeah. Just as things appear, so you might want a vacuum or a fan of sorts to pick these up. I guess this is probably also a iron level type approach to quarrying things out. So, yeah. So those are good enough to go, and we'll just charge that up real quick. Also, check. Doesn't seem to be. Okay. Doesn't seem to be clear if that's possible or not. So, we'll actually try an item frame as well and see if we can find out information inside it, which we can't, because it's just an item. So, that's pretty much the fractioning tower. While that's still charging. Try and put some upgrades in here. So I think it was, if I remember correctly, the gear. Here we go. Exosuit. So the boots and otherwise. So you can add an additional to the exosuit. My guess is that it's only for the chest plate. We should see if it's possible. No, so you can on that. So that is. 1 and 3, we apply that. It doesn't display it there, but obviously we can still do that. Eye of Ender. Can't put it in. Don't have a regular diamond to go off of, either. Piston, seems to be only for the other though. I'd guess for the arm length. Don't have a regular piston, which I forgot access to here. And obviously, I'm not going to show them in this video, but either way. Let's see what we can mine with this. So, we can mine dirt, we can mine cobble, if we go to ores, we'll be able to see that we can mine gold, but possibly not obsidian. Nope. So, thanks so much for watching, and goodbye.